Admiral McRaven, so this is the first time that you've really sat down to talk about this in detail?
It is in detail, yes.
So, tell us the story.
In November of 2010, Admiral Mullen came to Afghanistan. And he said the CIA had a lead on bin Laden and that I would probably be getting a call from the CIA at some point in time to come back to Washington, D.C. to take a look at the intelligence they had. I went back and forth to the CIA many times in the course of the next several months. The intelligence was good, but it certainly was not to the level of accuracy that we could say categorically, yes, this is bin Laden.
And did President Obama weigh in on your actual military plan at any point?
Oh, he did. We had a conversation, again, across the course of a number of meetings. At some point in time, the president said, well, can you do this? And I was candid with him. I said, Mr. President, I don't know if we can do this until I have an opportunity to bring in the SEALs in this case and the helicopter pilots from the 160th and rehearse it. We built up a mini headquarters at the undisclosed location in order for me and my staff to rehearse our roles in this as well. But after the course of the 3 weeks, I was able to go back to the president and his national security team and report that we had done the rehearsals and I was confident we could do the mission. The president called me on Friday night, my time, I believe, and we had a great conversation. He said, what do you think? I said, well, Mr. President, if he's there, we'll get him, and if he's not, we'll come home. So everything went exactly as planned, until obviously as we came around the corner and the first helicopter came in, it lost lift.
Do you remember what you told people back in Washington when this helicopter went down?
I think I said we're moving on to plan B. The guys were in the helicopter, moved, they continued on with their basic mission, which was to secure one of the outer, smaller compounds, and then to move into the lower level of the living quarters. The guys on the outside swung through initially. What appeared to be a door turned out to be a false door. So the compound had actually been built with the express purpose of protecting bin Laden. So they had to come through another entrance. They all kind of collectively got together and then moved accordingly up the three flights of stairs to get to where bin Laden was on the third deck.
What happened then?
And then as they moved up to the third level, the first operator coming up saw bin Laden peeking out through the door. And as he and I talked later, he said, I knew immediately it was bin Laden. And again, you have to understand, it was dark inside the house. The operators are wearing night vision goggles, so your view is not perfect. It's not like daylight. It's very good, but it's not perfect. Your adrenaline is pumping. You've just come up three flights of stairs. You've had to engage a couple of combatants, and now all of a sudden you get to the top of the stairs, and there bin Laden is. And the operators did what they again had planned to do, which was they flowed into the room. I got the code word Geronimo back, but it took me a minute to wonder whether or not Geronimo meant we had captured bin Laden or we had killed bin Laden. And then again, this kind of all of a sudden, Geronimo, it doesn't say on our mission execution checklist that he's killed. It just says, we've kind of gotten the target. So I had to go back and ask the question, was Geronimo EKIA, enemy killed in action? And the word came back that, yes, Geronimo EKIA.